Welcome to Getting to Know You, residents and staff of Stonebridge. Except that this is an exception. This is neither a resident nor a staff person, but a special production. And I think it fits well after Thanksgiving. We've had, when we were showing it to you, you had a lovely dinner, you said lots of things that you're thankful for, and then Friday, what do? You do something different. Maybe you go to a football game. Maybe you have time to sit around the table and just reminisce. So we, actually, Jock McFarland's idea, and I agree, that's how I can say we, that thought we would do something that would contribute to the reminiscing part of Thanksgiving. And that is, we would like to show you the imaginative special feature of the birthday celebration for 15 people who turned 90 this year. It happened earlier this month, and they were born, if you did your math, in 1932. And at Julia Cole's suggestion, Jock put together a sequence, we couldn't figure out the right term actually, of who and what were memorable in that year. So if you saw it, or if you did not, take a look, and I think you will enjoy it, either with a first watching, or a second, or a third watching. But if you were not born in 1932, the natural response is to say, well, what did happen the year I was born? I want a sequence too. Well, we'll get to that later. I can tell you that I know one thing that happened in 1936, the year I was born, because my mother tells me, and she told me often, that I cried very loudly as a baby during the radio speech of the King of England when he abdicated his role to marry Wallis Simpson, the divorcee. And I know now that was in 1936, the year I was born. I'll never forget it. So enjoy the events of people and whatever else happened in 1932, and think of your own year, and then stay on and watch for the final part of this program.
Let's start over.
Okay. Welcome, Jock, to this side of the camera.
Well, it's something different, that's for sure.
And you reminded me that there was one brief moment when you were in front of the camera.
Yeah, we did briefly, but anyway, the 1932 video slash photo thing, everything on the that was you just saw, I got from the web except for one thing, and that was the teacher's contract. That actually is something that's a family heirloom, if you want to call that. It was my mother-in-law's contract in for the 1932-33 school year, at which point she was to get $97 a month. And if she got married, and it was only if she was, it was a she, that didn't apply to men. The women could not get married and still stay on the contract. And so I tried to do is everything else was from the web, the pictures, the video, and tried to look at the things that were the life and the books and the music and the sports and the news. The things, because we wanted it to be silent, it was to just to be sort of a background for a party rather than something to sit in the theater and watch. It was silent. And so, in case you were wondering, the little bit with Amelia Earhart, she was telling you that when she finished her flight across the Atlantic and was landing in a farmer's field, she buzzed the field to scare the cows away, and then she landed and taxied up to the farmhouse and said she was there. You missed the Tarzan yell in the movie trailer.
Did you insert it? I forgot.
No, we didn't insert any music.
Okay. No, you didn't insert the Tarzan yell.
No. Okay. No, that's what I say. It's the stuff that
it wasn't
that,
there.
That okay. wasn't there.
I forgot.
And we had clip that I had of Babe Ruth calling the home run in the 32 series. We had Babe Ruth's voice commenting on his going to bat in that the different strike one, strike two, that he saw them but he didn't like them, he didn't swing at them, and then he pointed to the flagpole and hit it out of the park. And of course, any of the songs for in the music part, Bing Crosby, Kate Smith. It was interesting. One of the number one top hits of 1932 was Please by Bing Crosby. Please raise your hand if you ever heard of Please. I certainly have.
I never did, no.
I mean, as of, opposed to Night and Day and All of Me, which have been classic forever.
Mm-hmm. One of the nice things about this, when you were focusing on 1932, enough people realized that some things that happened in 1932 stayed on, and it was really our youth in a way that, or we were babies, but that amazing how much carried through to the 40s and so on.
Well, yeah, and particularly the entertainers and even the books. I mean, how many different things that were printed then that yeah. were still freshman English.
Yeah, what is it, Farewell to Arms? That was that one of the 1932 one of the Hemingways, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah, there was a Hemingway yeah. and Ernest Caldwell, Aldous Huxley, that's the one I'm blanking on
right,
the name.
Right, Brave New World.
Brave New World, yeah, thank you, yeah. Okay. And the one thing, the news thing, which I think I sort of had heard of roughly, but had no idea the extent of it, was the Bonus March. And I'm sure the scene of them storming the Capitol mm-hmm. brought back more
yes.
recent memories.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it was mentioned there that the army that was called in to disperse them was being led by General Douglas MacArthur.
Right.
And George Patton was one of his cohorts in helping it. So, from everyone, the 15 people here to Elizabeth Taylor, to Debbie Reynolds, to Cash, and Loretta Lynn, happy birthday, and many, many more.
Right, and we even got a laugh in a couple of places, like when the Sears Roebuck catalog came up, people immediately thought of Amazon or online buy.
The online buy.
Yeah, it was really fascinating.
The one image I regret, I couldn't find one that was, I found some, but they weren't of quality that to be able to show up on the screen, they'd be all fuzzy, was the fact that you could buy a house on Sears Roebuck, mm-hmm. and it would be delivered in a truck. I mean, that must have been the first IKEA, because I'm sure you had stuff left over by the time you were done.
Well, thank you, Jock, for putting it together. We're calling it a sequence, and you explained to me that it's like a movie, that it just sort of goes along piece by piece because you spatchcocked it together that way. That's the technical part of it.
But it's
really, I hope the conversation we're having is one that people will have when they watch it and say what they like the best or who knew, because that's really what makes it a lot of fun. And people really enjoyed it that day. They applauded, and I think you ran it again. At least it was up twice, I think.
Well, it was up continuously, really,
yeah, okay.
but we did have everybody stop once because it was good conversation and good food, and it was a good party, and it's nice to remember it.
Right. So enjoy this in your post-Thanksgiving extra special times, and thank you for watching Getting to Know You. We promise you people next time.